Team Cinch in the house today, so y'all come up here and hang out with us. First, I want to introduce 8-time world champion calf roper, the legendary Mr. Joe Beaver. Give him a hand, folks. First one. 6-time NFR qualifier calf roper, Tyson Durfey. Give him a hand. Tyson, how you doing? Up next, 4-time NFR qualifier calf roper, Shane Hanchey. Hello, Shane. Good. Next up, 3-time NFR qualifier, header Eric Rogers. Hello, Eric. How you doing? All right, guys, sit down, get comfortable. Whew, how's it going? I bet you guys have been busy, huh? Every one of you, I bet.
If you're not busy this time of year, you're not doing what you're supposed to do.
Yeah, you're doing something wrong.
These guys are busy every night, and they better be busy all day or they're not making any money.
That's right.
Ain't that the truth?
Yeah, that's right, that's right. Joe, start with you, man. 8-time world champ. We all look up to you, you know, whether it's tripping steers, calf roping, heading. I'm sure you can heal. Bulldog, whatever. Yeah, I mean, whatever it is, man. As far as this whole NFR deal, I mean, you've been here, done that. Talk about, you know, everything that's going on out here this week and kind of the buildup every night.
Well, you know, the part of it, a lot of people don't get to see or understand what these guys go through. You know, at nighttime is the easy part. Roping's the easy part.
Yeah.
You know, you got from 6 o'clock, you start, you know, getting things ready and you're done by 8 o'clock. That's the easy part. But what makes a career and what makes all your work and blood, sweat, and tears worthwhile is when you go out there and you solicit yourself because you've made a name or because you're a pretty good guy that would represent the company well, and you get the sponsors and endorsements of the people, then you have to work that during the day. That's your job.
Yeah.
Our job is to mingle with the people, to let them know good days are bad nights, good nights are bad nights, the next day. You got to be able to stop, take pictures, shake hands, and,
sure.
and appreciate what you got.
You bet.
You know, when we started the deal in about 1990, I'm going to say 3 or 4, there was about 6 of us. Jim Sharp, Tuff Edelman, Ty Murray, Charmaine James, Jake Clay, and myself. And we kind of all got banded together and decided we wouldn't sign for less than this amount. We wouldn't sign unless 3 of us were included.
Yeah.
You know, back then it was, we were in uncharted waters with sponsors and endorsees, and you know, it's just built up to where these guys have a lot of chances to make money before they get to the arena. Once you let an NFR qualifier get to that Thomas and Mac, he's on easy street.
Right, sure, sure. Tyson, we're gonna move over to you. You had a little bad luck last night, but talk about your week so far. We're starting round 4 tonight.
You know, as far as I'm concerned, it starts for me tonight.
Right.
You know, the first round had a strong calf, kind of got a little bit of a bad go, was 9, got by her. Second go around, calf hopped, coming out of the chute, got the bear. And last night I just got up trying to win,
right.
you know, a good paycheck. So
sure.
for me, it starts at 9.
Right, and it's so early. I mean, you know, at this level, you guys don't worry about, you know, anything like that.
He just said it starts tonight, but that's a fact, people. It's $19,000
right.
a night.
Yeah.
You rope all month for $19,000
yeah.
if you have a good month.
Sure.
You know, so if you let anything bother you from the night before, hence, we'll just take a little page out of Cody O's book.
Yeah.
His hop the night before and he runs through the barrier too. I honestly say, you know, if anybody, you wonder about the start here and we talk about how important it is, there's not a rodeo in America that we go, well, they go to now, whatever, that you don't pick your push man. Your push man is about the third most important part of that run. Because no matter how much I like and care and respect Taylor Bounds, he's not going to push my calf.
Right,
he
sure.
weighs 130.
Yeah.
My calf weighs 240.
Yeah.
He's not going to help me, you know?
Right.
So, and not picking on people or hitting, calling them out. But in the second round, I thought there were about 4 broke barriers due to lack of effort from the push man. Now, he's trying, don't get me wrong. It's not effort that he's not putting out. He just maybe hadn't pushed a lot of calves
right.
for money that are fresh and, you know, it makes a difference. I always said if they let me bring my own push man out here, I could have it on him before my horse left the box.
Sure.
Because you know that's that important to get him started. And in Tyson's defense and Cody and a few others, and some guys that were late. I think they were late because, you know, their calves just weren't leaving.
Yeah.
reruns start tonight. The start will be different. He starts overnight for 20,000. He should have a big week.
Well, I think that'd be a good job for me. Wear my suit. I'll go down there, push them calves. You guys will be all right.
You'll have a sheet of your suit when you get through.
Hey, man. Yeah. I'll be on TV, though.
Hey, no
so
offense,
be all right.
But if it was up to us, we'd have Dean Gorsuch punching our calves.
Yeah. Exactly. Shane Hanchey, last night you were 6'9". Man, I didn't see a single mistake in that run. And I don't know. I don't know if I've seen anybody get off a horse that quick and down the, you know, and the flank was smooth, tie, everything. Talk about your run last night a little bit.
Oh, you know, I had a good calf for sure. I'll be the first one to admit that. But like Joe said, that's the easy parts were open. And we just got to stay focused and do our job. And first time I ever tied on the 6th NFR last night was in my career. And I'll be damned if I didn't win second place.
Oh, yeah.
You know that guy, though, that beat you, that
I'll take my second behind you.
I've tied him before a few times. We watched, we meet down there usually every night in either Justin Healy room or the contestant lounge or whatever. And Hanchey said, look, watch my calf. So I watch his calf and I said, woo, man, you know, that's going to win the go round.
Yeah.
And he said, watch Cody's. And I watched Cody's and I said, well, you're first and second.
Yeah.
You know, but when calves are that good, when you watch them, you know they're that good. You put these caliber guys on that good of cattle,
right.
You know, they make me look good because I can predict what's going to happen.
You know what's fixing to
happen. Yeah, and last night I thought that was two of the best runs. And the reason is, they didn't look fast.
Right.
They looked like they were just practicing. First thing you know, 6'7", 6'9". That sets you up for the rest of the week. As Tyson said, his starts tonight. Mm-hmm. Shane's building on the first and third rounds, right. So he's in a good spot.
Sure. And Tyson, I wanted to add that I blacked it out today just because you were going to be on the show. So I thought I'd do that for you. Erich Rogers, let's see here. The first round, Corey led the steer. The second round, y'all split the round. Last night, Corey led the steer. So by our calculations, you should do to win the round tonight. Talk about your run so far.
First round, we had a little ball. We got a leg.
Right.
Second round, we had a place where we split the round. And last night, a steer didn't take off very good. And I kind of run through the barrier and got him and kind of got lucky there, got a leg. He was right at the dew claw there.
Yeah.
But we got him down and we're still on average. So
sure.
We'll put that behind us and look forward for tonight.
Yeah.
Going.
Not only two loops.
Yeah.
You know, we talk about two loops being a major difference now in the team roping. You know, do I like it? One aspect, yes, I like it. And the other aspect, I don't. But it makes it so important. If you're going to be late, and we saw some of that in the first round, two or three rounds, because I go back to saying, it's the first run of the time to hit cattle. These guys don't know if they're going to leave sharp or not. Okay, if you're in doubt, break the barrier. Because if you get outrun and you miss the back end of team roping with two loops, you're already one steer down. Well, when you're one steer down, you start taking more chances for go-rounds, then you miss another two steers down.
Right.
So I thought last night, yeah, he broke the barrier, but you can't panic. You still got to catch him. Corey, like you said, I mean, Duke clawed one. But guess what? They got three times.
Yeah, exactly. We've got a lot of calf ropers up here. But Erich, you rope calves as well, right?
Yeah, a little bit.
Kind of throughout the year? Tell us about that a little.
Through Indian rodeos and kind of some of the amateur rodeos. Recently bought a horse, Joe. So.
Oh, yeah.
Let me throw this in there.
Oh, okay? Yes, do it.
And he's one of my dear friends. I just talked to him. But nobody will even challenge Trevor Brazil.
Right.
Nobody will even scare him. You know, if you at least put a rock in his boot and aggravate him.
Yeah, something.
You know, something. This guy's got a chance. Shane Proctor, mm-hmm. Rides bulls great.
Right.
Rubs calves pretty good.
Right.
You know, tough, rubs calves great. Yeah. Team rubs pretty good.
Yeah.
There's Jesse Cruz, rump riding past world champion. Guess what? Rubs calves pretty good.
Yeah.
I would like to see somebody like Erich that's young and talented at least work that other event enough so God forbid anything happening. But I know when I was chasing Ty Murray, he was like Trevor Brazil. You know, if Ty Murray didn't get hurt, guess what? He went all around.
Right, sure.
That's just the way it was.
Exactly.
Because in three events, he was so phenomenal, you couldn't beat him.
Right.
That's when we got Trevor Brazil. But you never know. If something happens, you got to be close enough to have a chance. And I really think, and I'd worked the Indian Finals out here for the last 5 years, I think, and I've watched Erich Rogers mature in his roping. And honest to goodness, people, I think there's a chance here. And I'm not going to say he's going to overtake Trevor Brazil because this is not going to happen.
Yeah.
But he could scare him.
Sure, exactly. Shane, talk about your horse Riata for us.
Oh, yeah, he's been my main ride since I've been 15 years old. And, you know, had a little setback last year. Didn't get to ride him here.
Right.
So to come out on that first round this year on him and win the day money meant a lot more than what people think, and they think it meant a lot. So, just having that ease, that confidence that I have on him, I know he's got my back, and as long as we keep going like this, I'm excited for the next 7 days.
All right, sure, exactly. Tyson, you've had a very eventful year. You know, you've recently got married. Married or getting married?
No, I just got married.
Good deal. That's what I thought.
Yeah, she's got me locked down.
Oh, yeah.
So all you girls out there, just know that I'm married.
Back away. And, country singer?
Yeah. Good thing, but I'm not. Because you got time.
Yeah, Shane Hanchey's not. That's right. And Shay Fisher, she was up here yesterday and performed. And I don't know if she's here with us today, but.
I don't know.
Yeah, she sings.
I'm sure she's got a watchful eye on me.
Oh, yeah. Talk about your year, though. You came in here, you'd won a lot of money, and you've had a great year. You know, kind of what sticks out. Talk about your year a little bit.
You know, I'll just start from the beginning.
Yeah.
Last year, I missed the finals.
Right.
You know, barely. And after that, it lit a fire in me like I never had. You know, I always thought of myself as a guy that could make the NFR year in and year out. And that one year you don't make it, that lights a fire underneath you like you've never seen in your life. At that point, I went home. I didn't have the money to buy a bunch of rope and calves, but I borrowed it.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't have the money to buy horsepower, but I borrowed it and I bought them.
Sure.
You know, I worked my tail on the ground, got a personal trainer, went to working out 2 hours every day, running 30 head a day.
Yeah.
And it was amazing. Yep. I started winning again. I don't know how that works. Yeah, imagine that.
Yep.
But we've been able to carry through that momentum for the rest of the year. And, you know, I had a great year, you know, up to this point.
Sure.
I just got to keep that train moving forward.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I got to be looking for the next one. Was lucky enough to win a lot at a lot of the big rodeos. Cheyenne, Salinas, Reno. Didn't win them, but won second a lot.
Right, sure, sure.
And coming into the finals, you know, I just got to go for the go-rounds and let it happen.
Sure, exactly. Joe, you've got front row seat down there. And talk about the stock this year, you know, the steers versus the past. Talk about how good the calves are. Touch on that.
It's the best set of calves I've ever seen roped out here. I mean, you might pick one or two out of each set. They have three sets of 15, so they'll rope them each first three rounds and they'll start the reruns. The little set is honestly, you just dictate how fast you time.
Yeah.
They're going to cause some people to run over themselves, because if you don't stay in the stirrup long enough to pull their head around and keep them on their feet, you're not going to do anything.
Yeah.
They don't kick. They don't run too hard. There's just tons of chances. I think the middle pin that they rope, the bigger pin, was really good. They just kind of surprised a few people who started.
Right.
And last night is by far, you can't ask for a better set of calves at the national finals.
Amen to that.
Yeah.
Stacy's done a heck of a job with them. I mean, this is by far, it's my sixth trip to the regular national finals, and it by far is the best set of calves I've ever seen in my life.
Team Ropeman, I was glad to see a change. To be honest with you, it is so hard. And all the armchair team ropers all over the country text me every night for the last 4 years, you know, oh, I can't believe they can't catch them. When you're throwing over the chute, what you have to do to Thomas and Mack to win anything, the team rope, to win first, second, or third. You know, you see a header, they get a swing off in the box and they're throwing. It is so hard to keep it on a set of horns that are like that pink dummy without his horns on.
Yeah.
You know, it's so hard, guys, to go in fast, to keep it on there, keep it tight, and then stay up over your horse enough to give a handle.
Mm-hmm.
This year, honestly, I think it's been about 0-2 since they were this big.
Right.
Big frame. I can't remember who got the steers. I think Matt got them. I'm not sure. But he had to go through 500 head to get this 75. Every one of them have a big rack, number one set of horns. They have big bodies. They're strong. They'll take the hit.
Yeah.
They're going to change the team roping up. It's going to be even better.
I thought what kind of defined it all, you know, first time NFR qualifier Stetson Vest comes out there and puts one wrap, you know, on his first run, and I thought, this is going to be...
That's the change.
Yeah.
That's the change from now, say, 10 years ago.
Right, sure.
You know, the first three or four rounds, we didn't even think about it.
Right.
Because they were strong, and they were big, and they were... But it's all about change.
Yeah.
It's TV. It's a show out there now. You know, you got to have it fast-paced. You got to have it in and out. You got to build time. So they've tied them. You know, these calves have more runs on before the finals from the post-flaming time than ours would 10 years ago, throughout the finals included.
Right, sure.
So, but it's all about, it's okay. It's all about the change. You know, everybody says, well, I remember back in the day, y'all had to, yeah, that's why I've got a hip replacement.
And oh, yeah.
Six knee surgeries, you know, that's the reason for the season. So it doesn't hurt to change.
And it's kind of like, you know, when you're playing golf and it's windy outside, instead of complaining about it, everybody's playing windy golf that day. You know, everybody's roping the same cattle, that kind of deal. Erich, talk to us a little bit about, as far as the head knee and the size of these steers. You know, even on TV, it kind of looks like that they aren't moving that fast, but I think it's because they're so big. You know, if you're behind or anything like that, you know, they're still going to outrun you. You know, that kind of deal. Talk about that a little bit.
Yeah, these steers here, they're just a little bigger, framery, like Joe said.
Yeah.
They kind of have a hard, something like last night, a steer might get hung up in the chute coming out, you know, but once they get out of there, they're going on and they're moving. And they're still big. They're bigger and a lot stronger where you can reach and just go ahead and come back up the wall as hard as you can, and they're going to hit and they're going to clean up and make it that much easier instead of having the smaller steers and try to put a handle on them when you're trying to go fast. So this year's steers are a good set of steers.
Yeah.
And then, like Joe was saying, the horns are what makes a lot of difference.
Right.
Guys like to go fast and kind of pop it off the horn. You know, the first year I made the finals, they had itty-bitty horns like this.
Yeah.
You know, and this year they got them bigger horns, and it's kind of went old school.
Yeah.
You know, if we had the leather wraps, that would have been perfect.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, but there's good pin of steers, and they're going to be good all week long.
Right,
they're
sure.
Going to be tonight's going to be the second run on them, you know, so it's going to be a good roping from here on out.
Joe, touch on that a little bit, you know, just – I kind of like to talk about the behind-the-scenes stuff that people don't know about. The calves and the steers have been through three times, so everybody was just going on what they videoed in the practice.
You're going on the field. Right. Tonight, you know, everybody, they have tape down there on all the previous go-arounds, which is really nice because we used to have our wives do it.
Oh, yeah.
You know, run back to the trailer and watch it and run back up, you know. So, you know, they have tape down there. Everybody, if you want to know what yours did, go watch it. But with that said, you also have to remember that was the first one.
All right, sure.
And a guy can get tricked trying to make too good of a plan out of it.
Yeah,
This is reaction. The start never changes. It's they go, you go. You go before them, you break the barrier.
Yeah.
You see a necro, people get late. It doesn't change. But at least now you can go see what they did. Now, in the steer wrestling school, this is going to help with the tape. Because this is the first year in a long time they've had three pins of big body, slow handling steers.
Mm-hmm.
Steer got a lot of power in their necks. If you watch them, a lot of guys are catching them. They're getting their heads about time their feet at the ground. Steers are pulling them back over their knees. When they are, that's when steers tuck their heads and the guys are missing the nose.
Right.
So if you've watched that and you run a steer and let him do the same thing to you, then you're not very smart.
Right, sure.
You know, but if you watch that and say, okay, I gotta have his head when my right foot hits bent, I've gotta have his head picked up so I can hook the nose before he backs down the arena. I think in the steer wrestling, it's going to make a huge difference.
Right.
Team roping, maybe a little calf roping, maybe a touch, but they're going to do what they're going to do. But the steer wrestling, it's going to make a big difference.
Right, sure. Shane Hanchey, staying on the topic of behind the scenes, you get out there to the arena, you know, you've been doing this kind of stuff all day long. You get out there, walk us through kind of what you go through all the way up until you ride in the box. You know, kind of what do you do to get prepared every night?
Yeah, you know, I get out there at about 5:15 when they draw them, and you know, I check out the draw, and me and Tyson and a few other guys get there early.
Yeah.
We kind of check it out to make sure, you know, nothing weird goes on, or, you know, we rope an extra or anything like that. So we go over there pretty early, and I check it out. And that contestant lounge usually has some football games.
Oh, yeah.
I like to hang out and watch that and kind of take my mind off stuff. And then about 6 o'clock, I'll go to the sports medicine room, and they'll stretch me out, put some heat on my groins and stuff. And, you know, then grand entry time, which will light a fire in anybody.
Oh, yeah.
I see them gates crack and the lights shine. And then, you know, really, once the bareback riding starts, it seems like you look up and they're waiting for you to tie your rope on, almost, you know.
Right.
I like to go get my second loop string during the bareback, and I'll kind of sit right there and talk to Joe, and he'll remind me of the main goals I need to focus on that night. And, you know, from there on, I make sure I'm watching my man Casey Martin, the Bulldog, from Sulphur. And after I watch him, I help a few guys in the box and the heading. And bronc riding time, I like to go get stretched out and you know, just remind myself what we need to do.
Right.
And then we're ready to go.
And I see that a lot. Go ahead, Jeff.
Well, I'm going to say it's a huge difference, too. You know, if anybody been here years ago, we used to come in the arena.
Uh-huh.
And in the moat, it was right down. You know, you talk about get you ready. Because you would come in, and as they're riding Bronx, you're sitting against between the go what are now the go buckle seats. You're
right.
Sitting between the bleachers and the fence. And it gave you a feel. You know, it gave you a vibe. It got you ready. And now people, they're backed up a tunnel.
Right.
A dark tunnel.
Can you hear back there? Do you know what's going on right
now? Not very good.
Yeah, not hardly. You know, when
and you can't watch.
No, you can't see nothing. You miss half your event because you're back there in a tunnel that's about 5.5 feet wide.
Wow.
And there's 10 horses deep.
Yeah.
You know, you're just waiting one guy after the next.
And you don't get a chance to get all ready.
No.
You know, when Tyson rides in the box, or you see a guy, and I go through this all in my clinics. You know, all these kids, they get ready to rope and they swing however, you know, and I said, look, when you see a guy ride in the box at the national finals, and the last thing he does is he's up front swinging, getting ready, that's not for you. He could care less what you take at home.
Right.
That's because he's been sitting back there for 10 minutes where you can't even swing your rope.
Right, sure.
And you better get muscle memory and be ready for the next thing to happen.
Right.
So in these guys' defense, it was like that the last 5 years I roped there. I mean, it's not. But man, it was a different feel when you could be in the midst of 17,000 and the bronc riding, you know, and them guys getting thrown right by you or Mark and 80.
Right.
And by the time they let me ride in arena back then, you know, I could tie a grizzly bear at 80.
Oh, yeah.
You know, so these guys do that. I mean, and I did it. It's not that bad, but it is a special type of mental prepare that you have to do to be ready to ride the box.
Yeah, not only for us, but for our horses too.
Yeah,
you
sure.
know, you talk about a horse that's sitting back there in the quiet, you know, in a little alley. It's, you know, somewhat dark. And as soon as you ride through that gate, bam,
it's
like a bomb went off. We got 18,000 people screaming and hollering.
Right.
And that horse is thinking, oh no, you know,
oh,
but
yeah.
It takes a special kind of horse to work in this arena.
Right,
and Joe knows that. We all know that.
Oh yeah. And Joe, this may have something to do with it, but I noticed that the Robin Fiesta and Angelo this year, Pearl, Cody's horse, had maybe some sort of earplugs. What is that about?
I plugged every horse I ever rode here.
What is that? It's
you know, we always use cat balls. They have all kinds of different kinds, but they're soft, they're squishy, and they're about a Pepco and all that. All that does is the noise. You don't mind the noise in front. You don't mind the noise up top. But noise behind a calf horse is hard to back into.
Right.
Because if you watch, when they flip their ears to hear stuff, they'll run them back when it's loud and hold them. They'll flip forward if you want a picture and all that.
Right,
you can get up
sure.
there and flip their ears. And you can, in a noise, or if you slam a gate, they'll look like that. But when noises are loud and aggravating, you'll see them laying back.
Right.
So if you rope one right there and you need 3 steps and his ears are laid back because that sound back there is bothering him, he's not apt to get back.
Right, sure.
So we plug their ears just to eliminate one thing that might cause a horse not to work.
Right. Erich, as far as we were talking about the steers, do you change the lay of your rope or anything as far as heading goes on cattle like this?
Yeah, I normally use an extra soft.
Uh-huh.
You know, like them classic ropes, you know, they get just a touch limber when they get cold.
Right.
This year I kind of went to a little firmer rope, kind of soft, and whenever that cool weather hits it makes it just enough to where it's almost an extra soft. So.
Right, sure.
It was a mad dash, wasn't it, to the classic booth?
Yeah.
Billy Bray had ropes hung out everywhere.
Oh,
we got
there,
saw the big horns, everybody. And Healing, too.
Mm-hmm.
You know, me and Erich and I talked about this the first night. He brought a gray horse here that he's riding and belongs to Jake Lombrey. He rides him at the Indian Finals.
Mm-hmm.
Best choice could ever made with these steers because he's big and he's strong and he can come back up. But I said in the very first interview that we did starting the week, I think the head horses, the best head horses, meaning the strongest ones come up the wall that face good, and the healers that can go a little old school and lay a big bottom strand loop on the ground are the teams that are going to be the ones that win the most money.
Yeah.
The little fast loops, you know, and the limber heel ropes, they're out the door this week.
Right. Shane Hanchey, when do you find out what calf you got for tonight?
We'll find out an hour and a half before, so
okay.
5:15, they'll have them plucked for us. And we'll get to watching tape and film. And, you know, like Joe said, not break it down too much because at the end of the day, when they go, you go, and it's all reaction once you get around the neck and see how fast you can go.
I guess you're still back to just roping calves, you know, when it comes down to it, right?
Do you really go out there that early?
Yeah, I get out there. I get out there at 5:15.
Trevor and I always, when I was making the finals, we always rode together from the hotel. And we had a deal. We had to be there. We were there between 6:25 and 6:40 because Great Entry was at 6:45.
Right, sure.
You know, but that's the different of the deal. You know, Shane and these guys and Tyson, they get out there and they're on top of the deal to see what happens. And it's everybody's got their own little niche. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
We just, every night I waited on him. Every night, because he just, and he jacked with him. Sometimes he'd be standing right over there. In the car, we'd have a limo in front, and I'd be looking for him, you know, and he'd text me, you know, smile, don't be so
good. Yeah, exactly.
So these guys, everybody has their own little niche, but what works for you, you have to be able to use and not worry about what other people do.
Right, sure, sure.
Because this is an individual sport. This isn't the youth soccer league. If you run down the field and don't fall, you don't get a trophy.
Right, yeah, exactly.
You got to win something.
There's
get
no
paid.
Participation.
Yeah, so that's kind of cool to see how different people
Yeah, exactly,
handle, you know?
Exactly. Before I forget, and y'all all just kind of chime in at the same time, but talk about Cinch as a sponsor and what they've done for you, you know, and how important they are in going down the road. Erich, we'll start with you, buddy.
Cinch, they got me geared up, you know, jeans, shirts, and they got some boots, you know. They help us out all year long, getting us clothes and showing and, you know, getting product out there and helping us look our best to perform,
sure.
you know. So
sure.
they do us a great job, and I like to thank them for everything they've done for me and helping me get down the road.
Right, absolutely, absolutely.
Yeah, you know, Cinch took a chance on me in 09. My rookie year, they said, yeah, you know, it's your rookie year. We would like to, you know, fit you out and some cool stuff. And they took a chance on me when nobody really knew who I was or anything like that. And I went on to win the rookie that year and didn't make the finals. And then they stuck with me, you know, and I made the finals the year after that. And ever since then, you know, I've always said these endorsements are awesome, but what comes the best out of them is your personal relationships with the people in the company, you know, with the Dave Deans and the Tracys and all that you strive for every day, you know, because at the end of the day, we're representing the best clothing line in American Western way of life, but we're closer than that. You
right,
know,
sure.
We're more of a friendship basis
right.
than anything, and that's truly what counts.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, the thing that I love about Cinch the most, and I've worn Cinch my whole life, you know, it took me 4 or 5 NFRs before I got a deal signed.
Right.
But once I was a member of that family I was in, you know, you look at Fred Whitfield, he's been with them for how many years? You know, 17 years. And not only that, but you look at a clothing line that wants to be involved with professional rodeo cowboys. That's not even allowed in the arena.
Right, sure.
And that's a whole nother topic we could get into. But you look on billboards, you look at individual rodeos and what they're doing. I mean, Cinch is blowing it up. They're trying their best to get on professional cowboys in professional rodeo.
Right,
it's amazing
sure.
to me.
Sure.
I love them.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, and I can tell you a story about being dedicated. I was with Rainer since 1993, okay? I have had the best relationship with that bunch of guys that you could ever have. But as time changes, people change, new people take over. There's only 2 or 3 of the old ones left in there, you know. My big focus is kids.
Mm-hmm.
I do about 30 clinics a year. I've got NFR guys here that I can't be any prouder to say that at one time I got to help them. You know, do I run out with it? No, because that's our business. But nothing makes you prouder than one of your boys to back up in the box that's been through your system, you know, to help.
Yes.
Okay, as times change, I broke away with my deal with Wrangler because they didn't want to go the kid route. You know, well, my big deal is the junior route finals. I have three big junior opens a year, 450 kids that ever open. You know, I do 30 clinics. My deal is kids.
Yep.
So I laid out. I didn't have a closed deal for 2 years, and I've been since 1993 an admin.
Yeah.
Tracy Austin Ivy is the reason I'm Cinch.
Yep.
She stayed after me. She talked to me about it. I told her my concerns. I told her what I had to do to make it work was I felt like the kids. I wanted help with my junior opens. I wanted my kids. Because guess what, people? These guys are young in their career, 6 years, 5 years, whatever. But like that, it'll be 15 years, you know, and they'll be done here. And we have to know that that next generation of kids is out there believing that somebody's promoting rodeo, the sport they're working at, promoting their lifestyle, and trying to bring them along in a good way. That's my relationship with Tracy Ivy. That's my relationship with Cinch.
Right.
So if a guy, once you know, you cross that bridge, you don't go back.
Right.
And I'm not saying that I don't have to have it, but I'm in a position now where it didn't matter if I didn't have it by my own. You know, so I've been 30 years doing this. But Cinch stepped in on the kid deal when everybody else let the kid deal drop. And that's why and Tracy Austin Ivy are the 2 reasons I'm where I'm at.
Right, good deal. I'm going to wrap it up by saying this. Erich Rogers, you'll win the round tonight. Shane Hanchey, my favorite calf horse going, Tyson Durfey. Tonight, it's time to, you know, we're going to turn it around for you. And Joe Beaver, you have changed the way we watch the NFR on television. And I really, from what I do, you know, we all love that you're eight-time world champ, but I love what you do. And guys, if y'all would give a hand right here for Team Cinch. And we really appreciate y'all being here. Amazing.